It's time to play everyone's favorite game show.
Wait, what?
How Canadian are you? And here's your host, Northern Lion.
Thank you, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls. Are you ready to play How Canadian Are You? Before we begin, let's go over the rules for those playing along at home. The object of the game is to correctly answer the definition of each Canadian phrase. Sinvicta is given 10 seconds to answer each question, but if you're playing along, feel free to pause the video and take as long as you wish. The scores will be tallied up at the end of the game, and to see how well you did, check the scoring system listed in the information box below. Question 1. What is a gong show?
A gong show.
A gong show.
Is this related to the gong show that was like in the 70s, perhaps? Or
although there were gong shows in the 70s, this is not related to the television program The Gong Show.
Okay. When Canadians fire off 21 salutes for someone who has passed.
That is incorrect. A gong show is a word commonly associated with Canadian hockey scene that implies a party that got a little too crazy.
Ah.
Maybe everybody got a little too drunk and things became chaotic.
So it'd be, if this were British, it'd be like that was a real banger or something.
Yeah, but I think gong show implies like more of a mess.
Oh, okay.
Like I think something could be, like you could be like, this parking lot is a gong show because it's just like busy and crazy and there's no rules.
So it's like a cluster truck.
Yes,
I got you.
I agree with you there.
I got you. All right. Well, 0 for 1, not bad. It's a good start, I suppose.
It's actually the worst you could be doing. Literally. But, okay. Question 2.
All right.
What is a double-double?
A double-double. I'm going to assume it's either a hockey or sports term, and that means that you've gotten 2 assists and 2 scores in the same game.
That is also incorrect. A double-double is a coffee that contains 2 sugars and 2 creams, commonly ordered at Tim Hortons.
What? What? They call it a double-double?
If you went into any Canadian Tim Hortons and said, I'll take a double-double, they would give you what you asked for.
Okay.
100%.
So what if you could walk in and say, hey, I want a triple double? Is that
that would be weird. You don't do that. You just order a double double.
Okay, you just order 2 double doubles and subtract 1 double out of it.
You could be like, give me 3 creams and 2 sugars or something, but Question 3. What is a Mickey?
A Mickey. I'm gonna say it's sort of like a hickey, but you get it from an Irishman. I don't know.
That is incorrect. Although that situation could be created as a result of consuming a Mickey.
It's a type of drink? Is it an alcoholic beverage?
It's an alcoholic beverage, but specifically, it's a small 375 milliliter bottle of liquor. A handle, I think, might be the American
analog. Okay. I know what a handle is, of course, being an ex-bartender and all, but...
Oh, freaking Tegan went down to the prom with a Mickey strap to her thigh. Would be an example of how you'd use that in an expression. Became a real gong show.
Oh, yeah. And then afterwards, for the hangover, we go get a double-double over at Tim's.
Oh, jeez. Maybe if you drive me there, you hoser.
Yeah. Don't you know?
Question 4. What is a toque?
A toque. That is another word for a beanie.
That is correct.
Yeah, there we go. You thought I was going to get blanked on this one, didn't you, audience?
I thought there was a chance.
Yeah. Fun fact, actually invented by Michael A.L. Fox.
Fun fact, Southern people who live in the Southern United States, that is not called a toboggan.
A toboggan
is a sled that you use to go down a hill in the snow.
I thought a toboggan was like one of the inflatable like tires, like those black tube tires that you push in the snow.
You know what we call that in Canada?
What?
Tube.
Okay. So you just go tubing.
That's just you go tubing, exactly.
That's a real gong show if too many people tubing.
Did you just create tubing? Because that's a Canadian phrase. I think you should get a bonus mark. Creating tubing out of thin air.
You know what? I'll take it. If the English judge is going to allow me, I will. I'll take it.
Well, I'm trying to act of going down a slow-moving river in an inner tube. I can't tell if it's Canadian only. A term perhaps invented in Muskoka, which is in Canada, used to describe the water sport of being pulled behind a fast-moving ski boat on a large inner tube. All right. This is a bonus point.
Okay, I'll take it.
Out of the ether, you got a bonus.
Sweet, thanks.
You're two out of four.
Two out of four, I think, yeah.
Question five. What is a Chesterfield?
Chesterfield. Just for clarity, are we talking about a firearm?
No.
Okay, a Chesterfield is a type of peanut butter.
That is incorrect.
Ugh.
A Chesterfield is a Canadian word for a couch or sofa, sometimes used to imply a more upscale couch or sofa.
So Canada has a specific name for a higher class of couch.
We call them Chesterfields.
Chesterfield. So if I
When I grew up, get your hands off the Chesterfield. Not even messing with you.
Get your hands off the Chesterfield.
If it was a brand name at one point, but now it's just it's an industry term.
Ugh. All right.
Question six. What is an eaves trough?
Eaves trough.
An eaves trough.
I'm going to say it's not related to the Binding of Isaac. I'm going to say it's probably not going to be related to spying. So an eaves trough is the Canadian word for patio.
Semi-close, but also undeniably incorrect.
An
eaves trough is the word that we use for your rain gutters. You know, the gutters
that
catch the rain.
Yeah. We just call them gutters down here.
Yeah, eaves trough. You gotta go up on the, get up on the ladder and clean the eaves trough, eh? It's gonna cause a flood.
How dangerous is it to actually clean the gutters up in Canada during the winter time, especially?
I don't think you do it.
You just let it freeze and just...
Well, I think if it gets iced up, what's the worst that can happen?
So what's the Canadian protocol for dealing with a frozen up eaves trough?
Well, you freaking wait for it to melt.
Of course, it just makes so much sense.
That's what it's designed for.
Gotcha. Yeah. All right.
Question seven. What is a garburator?
Garburator.
Garburator.
A garburator, is this part of a car?
No.
Okay. A garburator is something that Canadians use to warm up their shoes before they go outside.
That is ignorant and incorrect. A garburator is a Canadian word for a garbage disposal that's built into your kitchen sink. Yeah, when you put like your little bit of food waste down there, and then you flip a light switch and it goes, and it chews it up.
Yeah, we call those garbage disposals down here.
We call it a garburator.
We also call it
a garbage disposal. But.
Yeah, it sort of makes sense. I prefer to think that the Canadians do have some sort of device that heats up their shoes before they go outside, though.
It's called a house.
All right, well, not a very inventive word for it, but I'll take it.
All right. Two for seven.
Yep.
Question eight.
Okay.
What is a pencil crayon?
A pencil crayon is... It's literally just a colored pencil.
That is 100% correct.
Yeah! Did you
know that one?
I've never heard them called penciled crayon, but I know what, like, colored pencils are. We use those all the time.
I won't deny. Color pencil makes way more sense, because that's what they are. Pencil crayons is not what they are.
I mean, that's just trying to cheat at Scrabble with all those syllables, extra syllables. Screw that.
I mean, it's two words. I mean, don't give us some credit up here.
If you put a dash, it might be cheating at Scrabble then.
Question nine. What is a stagette?
A stagette. That is...
A stagette.
S-T-A-G-E-T-T-E.
S-T-A-G-E-T-T-E.
Stagette. I'm going to give myself an extra 10 seconds here for clarification. A stagette is... It is... It's a... It's a baguette that's made out of venison.
That is incorrect. A stagette is another word in Canada for a bachelorette party.
Oh, that makes sense, because stag party, stagette party.
Exactly. What they call a combination bachelor and bachelorette party?
A gong show.
If you play your cards right. bring your pencil crayons. But we call it, and everyone might call it actually, I'm not sure, a buck and doe.
Buck and doe? No, I don't think I've ever heard that.
It's deer terminology, I guess.
Is deer hunting all that popular up in Canada?
Yes.
Would you say it's more popular than fishing?
No.
Okay. As long as fishing is still
fishing
number one.
Fishing's way more popular, I'd say. All right. Question 10.
All right.
What is a keener?
A keener.
A keener.
Keener. K-E-E-N-E-R?
That's correct.
A keener, that's... It's when someone gives you something to think about.
Like a question, you're like, oh, that's a keener.
Yeah, yeah, like that's a real keener right there, I tell you what, bud.
That is incorrect. A keener is a brown noser, you know?
Okay.
A teacher's pet, or somebody who is, somebody who beats the curve in your class and makes everybody else very angry. For example, the stagette is going to be a real gong show. Bring your Mickey, but don't invite the friggin' keener.
We'll all go tubing later.
We'll all go tubing in Muskoka. Yeah.
All right. Well, 3 for 10. I'll take the extra point, make it 3 for 10. So, what am I?
You are a discarded hockey puck.
Yay! It's better than being yellow snow. I appreciate the extra point for the out of the ether.
I wouldn't give it to you as charity, to be honest with you, because like that actually was amazing that you came up with tubing. By came up, I mean like it's already a phrase up
here.
Well,
yeah.
Out of nowhere, basically, you invented a phrase that's also Canadian.
I mean, let's just call it now. I'm half Canadian. It's that simple.
Well, no, you're like 30% Canadian.
Oh, okay. Well, that's fine. So.
Could be worse.
Thank you for watching, everyone. I do appreciate it. Also, a big thank you to Northern Lion for helping me out with this very special episode. If you'd like to see more of these kind of episodes, check the links down below. Also, make sure you go follow Northern Lion, subscribe to his channel as well. And of course, we will see you all next time. So long, everybody.